Hello friends and welcome back to the channel. So today's video is going to be a February budget recap, and I actually just got done filming my March budget. I'm gonna show you what we spent in February, how things went, and where we're at right now. So if you're still interested, keep on watching. As you can see, we brought in, or we anticipated bringing in, just about $6,100 in February, and we ended up bringing in about $260 more than we anticipated. So as you'll see, things fluctuate throughout our budget. As I've said in multiple other videos, this is just what works for us. We always try to budget less than what we anticipate making, because I've had a few too many months where I've gone into it assuming that we were making a certain amount and then the money didn't come through. So and then we were like kind of shit out of luck. So with that, I always budget less than what I anticipate. So it's just helpful for us. But then you'll see like our variable expenses vary then, because we have a little bit more income coming in. So that's just the way that I do things. That is because I have fixed income currently, and then I also have variable income, but my husband is entirely variable income. So right now, that's just what works for us, so that we make sure that we're not getting ourselves in a shitty place and we have to dig into our emergency fund. So that's where things are with that. As you can see, all of these fixed expenses are always the same. So we spent, so I noticed that that was actually what I was doing right when I started this video, which you guys didn't see, but I realized that our Netflix comes out on like the last day of the month, and because I'm paid the last day of the month, it gets confusing. So I'm just gonna pay for it twice in March, because February kind of like messed things up. But so we didn't pay for Netflix this month, but I'm gonna be double charged. Well, like, it'll come out twice in my budget in March. So that's just kind of how things are there. But otherwise, everything else is the same. Moving on to our debt, we did have one of our debts being a little bit higher than I was anticipating, but only by $3, so not a big deal. And then this one was like just under what I was anticipating paying as well. So this is a lot of money. That's what we spend in debt, and it's quite sickening, honestly, but it's something that we are working on. It's just, we had a really difficult end to last year, if you've been watching my channel. So we're still kind of like bouncing back from things. And instead of like throwing a bunch of money at debt, we're kind of saving a little bit or keeping it in rollover, because just in case something happens again with like variable income, or both of us have chronic illnesses. So sometimes you have to be a little bit more careful with that kind of stuff. So as much as I want to hit debt really quickly, we need to see what our refund looks like. Again, I get a pretty hefty income, but not hefty refund, but I make a good amount of money. So I do like the least amount of like whatever it's called. So it's not like that. It's just that I still get a little bit of a refund usually. However, my husband and I got married this year, and he isn't really good at paying his taxes throughout the year as like his own business owner. It's something with like combining money that we're still trying to figure out, is like the way that he deals with money versus the way that I deal with money. So we're a little unsure. I'm putting out into the universe that we're gonna bring home tons of money in refund, but he just wants to make sure that for some reason we don't have to pay. So that's why I'm just like chilling a little bit with putting anything toward debt. But we'll see. I'm thinking in like the next month or two, we're waiting for our taxes to go through again, because he has multiple streams of income that are all variable. We basically are like waiting on one company that hasn't like fully finished their tax stuff. So like we can't finish our taxes until that's done. So for me being like very impatient, I'm very annoyed about it, but it'll come out pretty soon. And then we can know, like, I don't want to pay anything in, so I am not putting that out into the universe, but like, I just want to know what's happening, and then we can move on from there. And then we'll start to like tackle debts, but we're definitely going to be tackling things like our credit cards first, just because even though these are higher amounts than like this one, say, this one has like a better interest rate than a lot of these other ones do. So that is what we're doing there. But just wanted to give you guys a little bit of a heads up, because if you're like, oh, you know, you'll see how much we had at the end of the month that I put into savings, and you might be like, why didn't you put that toward a credit card or something? And we're just waiting like a month or two more to see like where things are at, and then hopefully we'll be able to start throwing even little bits of income at some of these like massive credit cards. We're also thinking of looking into consolidating credit card debt, which I'm not really sure how to do, but just because some of these credit cards are like ridiculously high in interest. And yeah, so we need to like figure out what to do with that. So if anybody has any tips of or knows of any way to like consolidate credit card debt, let me know in the comments below, even if it's like that we can consolidate most of our credit card debt. I understand that like consolidation isn't always the best option, but like if I can go from 17 to 19% interest down to like 10, that's still better than what we're paying right now. So right now we're in that place where like we make a payment on our credit card and it doesn't really look like it did much. So I know that that can be a very slippery slope. And we're right on the cusp of like our businesses taking off. So I know eventually in this next year, in 2020, we're gonna have a much higher income in the next few months, but we're not there yet. But I don't want this shit to get like out of control. So that's where we're at with that stuff. That little tangent is over, but we spent $1,900, almost $2,000 on debt this month, which is, it like makes me want to cry every time I think about it. So I'm gonna move on. I'm aware of it. We're trying to do stuff about it, but it definitely, like, debt is like crippling. So anyway, moving on from that, and $250 over budget on groceries. And that is because we went to Costco. We're actually planning on taking something back that we bought at Costco because it didn't go as well. And then you can kind of see it here, but Ben had a client that he gets his like cash income from that we use for our groceries. And they called out twice. So that is basically like 1 week worth of groceries that we had to pay for out of this budget and that we weren't anticipating. That's where like the variable income can be very difficult. This is a consistent problem area, but this month, the reason that this happened is because that we went over by so much is because there's a few like little things in here, but a big thing was a couple of celebration dinners for my promotion. And I was in the mind frame of like, I'll be bringing in more money next month. So I'm going to take myself out. And this has been, oh, you guys don't even know. I got a promotion. I talk about it in my March budget. And without sounding ungrateful, it has been a very, very, very trying year with my job in the last year. And the last particularly 8 months where I have been doing two full-time jobs and only being compensated and recognized for one of those jobs. And I finally advocated, stood up for myself, fought for myself, and I finally was given a little bit of a bump. With that, however, they have now required that I go into the city 2 days a week. So a lot of that, or part of that bump in salary that I got, now has to go to commute budget. So I'm very grateful that I got more money and that it came in, and I'm very grateful for that option. And I'm very grateful that they aren't expecting me to work in the city every day, because it's like, it's not, I'm not able to for my health. But it still has been a very, very, very stressful last, particularly last 4 months. But I've been doing basically two people's jobs for 8 months now. And also, I lost my entire team about a year ago. So I have been, it's been an interesting year. So I did get a promotion and I did go out and celebrate it, because the promotion was kind of like, devastating in a way because I was anticipating a lot more than what they provided. I was anticipating back pay for the months that I worked this job and I didn't get it. So we were really banking on that back pay in order to like pay some of our debt and like make a bigger cushion in our savings account. So when we didn't get that, even though I did get a bump in salary, it definitely like rocked my world a little bit. So with that, we did go out and try to celebrate the promotion in order to think about the positives of it and like how grateful we are for the extra money every month and how grateful we are that I no longer have to fight that fight at work. So yeah, that's kind of where some of that money came in. But as you can see, there's quite a bit of different things that we spent, and that is just the way that we spent our money this month. So I'm not mad about it. Neither should you be. neither should you. I don't know. Moving on, I spent about $45 less than anticipated on my medication and supplements. I'm actually not going to be seeing the practitioner that I'm seeing that much longer. So this may change, but we do have to start paying for Ben's medications and supplements. So this is actually probably gonna go up pretty soon. Household, we went over quite a bit. We had to buy like a whole bunch of random stuff, and actually, this parchment paper we still haven't gotten from Amazon, so just wondering where that's at. $0 there. Spent about $2 less than I needed to on my personal spending. I got myself slippers and a book, and then what the heck is self date night? I don't even know. Maybe I got myself food. I have no idea what that is. I forget. Therapy, we spent $50. That was 4 individual sessions and 1 couple session. Moving on, spent $10 at the doctor from Quest. I was anticipating much more, but it was only 10. Utilities, we were under budget, which is great. So we were under budget a little bit there. Train and parking, we actually were able to not spend that much. I was able to use like the few train tickets that I had left over from like October. So we didn't use that full budget, but we will be using it in March. We went just $7 over on gas because we had to get Ben's car gas too. If you guys know, we have a second car, but we can't drive it very far. It's just like an old beater car, but it's nice to have two cars in case like Ben has my car and like I need to go to the doctor or I need to go to like Target or something. It can drive short distances, just not long distances. But with that, we like rarely fill the gas tank. And anyway, I named his car Mushu from Mulan, so that's why it says that. Moving on, I was just a little bit under on Cora's budget for her food. And then we were quite a bit over on miscellaneous, and that is because we were overcharged at Costco. So this is actually something that should be half of that. Plus, I think we're gonna get refunded entirely. So we went to Costco on Friday and we got there, we got our membership, didn't realize that they overcharged us until we left. They basically charged us for like the executive membership and we don't need that. So we were going to get that refunded, so it would only be $60. But when we went through Costco, so if you guys don't know, Benjamin and I eat like a very particular diet. We eat almost entirely organic food. And then we also, like, I don't eat gluten. We don't eat dairy. So there's a lot of like substitutes. And then we use non-toxic products. It's just a way of life that we like to live. And Costco just didn't have as much stuff in that way, at least when it comes to like vegetables and like fresh fruit and meat particularly. There was like barely any organic grass-fed meat, which is what we eat. So it didn't really make sense for us to go to Costco. So we might just cancel that entirely, which means we would get like $120 back to our account next month. So that's something that I have tasked Ben with doing this month or this week. I've been talking for a long time. Sorry, guys. Moving on. This is all the same, except these are the three things that I put into our sinking funds. And then this was how much money we had at the end of our month, and I normally would use that as rollover. We actually have enough income coming in this next month that we shouldn't need it. So I moved it to our savings account. It very easily can be like transferred back over if we need to, but I'm gonna try to start moving that over to savings if we have any extra versus rollover, unless we actually need the rollover. Otherwise, we'll spend the money on things like, you know, food and groceries and stuff. So that is what our February budget looked like. Leave me a comment down below if you'd like to know anything else. Otherwise, like this video if you liked it and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.